No, Madhurima, it's almost 9:20 now. Let's start, no?
Yes, sir. Please. I think
Yeah, if somebody joins later, let them join later, no problem.
Yes, sir. They will join in between the session also. No problem.
Because yesterday I left abruptly, so I want to at least finish that part. Then I'll take some examples today.
Yeah, today is also the last day of the session also.
Yes, sir. So we can take till 11 o'clock, right? There is no problem, right?
Yes, sir.
There won't be any meeting today, right? Okay. Okay, good morning, everybody. So thank you for coming for the third day. Being a Sunday, you guys have got up so early and come here to attend this session. That is good. So what we will do is जो भी कल किए थे वो एक्चुअली कंप्लीट करेंगे, क्योंकि वो एक्चुअली यू हैव टू लीव इट वेरी फास्ट. सो हम लोग वो कंप्लीट करेंगे, थोड़ा सा कंप्लीट करेंगे, थोड़ा सा ओवरव्यू दे देंगे, फिर आप लोग वो एक्सरसाइज लेके वो कर सकते हैं. देन नाउ आई एम शेयरिंग माई स्क्रीन. आई हैव सम बुक्स फॉर IoT एंड एम्बेडेड सिस्टम्स व्हिच पीपल हैव आस्क्ड. ओके, सो आई थिंक सम ऑफ दोस गाइस हु आस्क्ड मी यस्टरडे IoT बुक्स in the embedded system books I have. I think anyway, I think these people are recording this entire session, so you can actually collect those recordings and you can try seeing it how it looks like. So I'll give you some references. So some reference books. So the first reference book I have for IoT is Getting Started with IoT, okay, by Kuno Pfister. Okay, this is the author. Second book is Learning IoT by Peter. Third book is Principles, Practices, and Solutions for IoT by Timothy Chow. This is what I have actually studied. So this is a very good book. Then for embedded systems, there are several books. You can refer to any book that you want. But particularly, my personal opinion is I like books by Masidi. Okay, so this Masidi has written several books. Some are in 8051 microcontrollers, some are in PIC microcontrollers, some are in Atmel microcontrollers. So it varies. He has written several books. So but I really like those book of Masidis. Any book, I have personally read those books, so I like it. There is some book called Making Embedded Systems by Elysia. This will give you an overview of how the system looks like, what are all the different parts of the system. All these things is available. And the last book is like a Bible. The book is the Firmware Handbook. This you have to keep it in your library for references and all. So you can refer it for, it has lots of things. Lots of firmware details, how you have to proceed, and all these things. So, you have to, I think it's better to have this as a reference book. So, I have given my email ID also here. My email ID is sridevan@gmail.com. So, if anybody is interested in doing some projects or if you want to learn something, then you can actually write to me. Then we can discuss how to take it forward. So, if you are going to work in a group of persons, then you basically form a group and write to me together rather than writing individually, because it'll simply flood my email box. Okay. So I hope you guys have taken note of this. I'll again show this later on also towards the end of the session. Okay. So now we'll move on to where we left yesterday. So हम लोग एक नया प्रोसेसर बना रहे हैं. वो ये हमारा प्रोसेसर है. सो इट हैज व्हाट इट हैज वी हैव डिसाइडेड दैट इट विल हैव 4-bit रेजोल्यूशन. So then we decided how to draw the architecture. The architecture was something like this, where we had a bus, and then we had an ALU, which is going to do arithmetic logical unit, which is going to do addition or subtraction. And then you have one big control unit. This control unit is going to generate control signals. ठीक है? और हमारे पास चार रजिस्टर्स थे, R0, R1, R2 and R3. Okay, we had four registers, R0, R1, R2 and R3. And we had for the ALU. So if we have to add or subtract, then we need two registers which are very close to the ALU, which the ALU will access it. So as long as you put the numbers in A and B of the registers of ALU, then it will simply access it for doing the addition or subtraction. ठीक है? फिर ये जो भी आउटपुट आ रहा है ALU से वो G में डिपॉजिट करेगा. G एक और रजिस्टर है. सो ऑल दीज रजिस्टर्स आर 4-bit रजिस्टर्स. दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव डिसाइडेड दैट द प्रोसेसर शुड बी ऑफ 4 bits इनिशियली. इफ यू डिसाइड द प्रोसेसर टू बी 8 bits, 16 bits, 32 bits, देन ऑटोमेटिकली देन द होल every architecture, every register will have 32 bits or 8 bits or 16 bits like that. So ultimately the G will again be communicated back to your bus, and from the bus it will have access to other registers. So अभी क्या important चीज है, अभी हम लोग control signals define करना है. So पहला control signal क्या है, extern. मैं extern अभी define किया है. इसके बाद we have defined different control signals. So we'll see those control signals that we have defined. Okay. So we have taken some examples of one code. For example, this is a program that we want to execute in the processor. First one is load, second one is load, third one is load. Then we want to add, then we want to add one more. ठीक है, ये 3+5+6 करने के लिए. ठीक है, वो करने के लिए हम लोग सिर्फ एक ही इंस्ट्रक्शन ले रहे हैं पहले. So if you have taken only load, then load, what are all the control signals I require? I need extern. So the moment I give extern, then the data that is available in the external world is now getting deposited in my bus. So bus ke paas aa jayega. So ye aane ke baad hum log jo bhi register mein deposit karna hai, wo register ka in signal dena hai. So isliye hum log R0 in likha hua hai, fir RX in generalize kiya hai. So ye dono karne ke baad ye mera instruction complete ho gaya. So then I have to inform to give the next instruction. For that I have to give a signal called done. Theek hai, so done ho gaya. Similarly then we'll go to move. So move, what happens in move? So for example, we want to basically move one data from one register to another data. So move RX comma RY. So pehla wo RY ka out signal dena hai, so that register's values will go to bus. Iske baad hum log RX in dena hai. Iske baad ट्रांसफर तो हो गया, फिर डन करेंगे. ठीक है, नाउ वी विल कम टू ऐड व्हिच वी लेफ्ट यस्टरडे. सो ऐड के लिए क्या जनरलाइज करेंगे, ऐड R1 का R2 हमारा ठीक है, add R1 R2, R1 का R2 is our instruction. ठीक है, so add R1 का R2, so पहले क्या करना है, R2 का value A के पास जाना है. You'll see in the architecture. ठीक है, so R2 का value, जो भी R2 का value है, वो bus के पास आना है, और bus से we have to bring it to A. Similarly, that's R1. R1 का value bus के पास आना है, पर बस से बी को लेना है. ये आने के बाद एएलयू को इंस्ट्रक्शन देना है दैट यू हैव टू स्टार्ट डूइंग एन एडिशन. सो इसलिए वी आर यूजिंग वन मोर कंट्रोल सिग्नल कॉल्ड ऐड सब. ऐड सब आई विल यूज ऐड सब. इफ आई से ऐड सब इज इक्वल टू 0 देन इट इज ऐड. इफ इट इज 1 इट इज सबट्रैक्ट. दिस इज माय ओन वे ऑफ आंसरिंग इट. सो इफ यू वांट टू चेंज इट यू चेंज इट. इफ यू वांट टू पुट ऐड सब इज इक्वल टू 1 फॉर एडिशन 0 फॉर सबट्रैक्शन यू डू इट, नो प्रॉब्लम. देयर इज नो वन राइट आंसर. ये सभी आंसर्स राइट है, ये सिर्फ एक डिजाइन प्रॉब्लम है. कैसे डिजाइन करेंगे वो एक एक आदमी के ऊपर है. ठीक है, सो नाउ व्हाट वी हैव डन इज वी हैव टू पुट वन ऐड सब. द मोमेंट ऐड इज गिवन टू द एएलयू, देन दिस एएलयू विल टेक वैल्यूज ऑफ ए एंड बी एंड इट विल बेसिकली ऐड दीस टू एंड द आउटपुट विल गो एंड गेट डिपॉजिटेड इन रजिस्टर जी. जी में डिपॉजिट होगा. जी डिपॉजिट होने के बाद यहाँ पे मैं जी आउट का एक सिग्नल देना है कंट्रोल यूनिट से, सो दैट आई कैन टेक दिस वैल्यू एंड पुट इट बैक इनटू बस. सो वंस आई पुट इनटू जी आउट, ओके, वंस आई पुट इनटू दिस थिंग, वी विल राइट इट इन अ सेपरेट पेज. ठीक है, ऐड को राइट करेंगे, ऐड R1 कमा R2. इसका डेफिनेशन क्या है, R1 plus R2 करके फिर R1 रजिस्टर में डिपॉजिट करना. ठीक है, सो देन हाउ विल आई डू फॉर गो फॉर इट. सो ऐड, ओके, सो व्हाट विल हैपन, फर्स्ट थिंग इज आई विल टेक R2 आउट, देन दैट विल गो इनटू ए इन. नेक्स्ट आई विल टेक R1 आउट एंड दैट विल गो इनटू बी इन. ठीक है, फिर ऐड सब करके एक सिग्नल देना है इज इक्वल टू 0. ठीक है, देन द एएलयू विल परफॉर्म द एडिशन एंड देन इट विल डिपॉजिट इन जी. सो So the next thing is I'll give G out. So G out दे देंगे तो फिर G में जो भी values है वो actually it will come to bus. So bus के पास आ गया, फिर bus से हम लोग निकाल के फिर R1 के पास देना है क्योंकि the instructions definition is after doing addition the output will again go back to R1. So अभी R1 in देना है. इसके बाद सब complete हो गया, then I'll give you done. Okay, so then this entire exercise will basically contain, you see, subtraction and addition. You see how many control signals I require? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 control signals. Okay, and all these control signals has to go in sequence. For example, R2 out, when it is happening, it is transferring the data to the bus. Before that, if you give AN, then whatever was the value in the bus previously, that will come into AN, which is not what we want. We want R2's value to go into AN, right? So all these have to go in sequence. Okay. So how to decide whether this will go in sequence? The only way to decide whether these can go in sequence is by using a clock. Speed or clock or whatever you want to call it. Okay. That's why clock becomes very important. And that's why whenever we talk about a microcontroller or a microprocessor, we always say about clock. We'll always say, okay, what is the clock frequency of your microcontroller? So ये हमारा Arduino का board है, 16 megahertz है, 8 megahertz, 4 megahertz, like this. The reason why we say all these things is because a clock is the one which decides how to send in a sequential manner. ठीक है, कुछ doubts है क्या? Because कल थोड़ा सा जल्दी से हो गया ये. कुछ doubts है क्या? आप बता सकते हैं? You can unmute your mic and speak, or you can type. No doubt. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. ठीक है. So अभी मेरे पास time नहीं है. Anyway, I'll quickly introduce what is the next step. Then I'll leave it to you guys to think about it. Okay. इसका next step क्या है? अभी next step अभी control unit का जो भी control signal generate करना है वो decide किया है. And then we have also decided what is going to be my opcode. My opcode is going to be 6 bits. The first 2 bits will be reserved for instruction. Second 2 bits will be reserved for the first register RX, and the last 2 bits is reserved for RY. Except for load instruction, RY is present in every other instruction. Move is also RY, add is also RY, sub also has RX comma R. ठीक है? So अभी क्या है? Now we have to see. So अभी ये सारे मशीन हैं. ये मशीन को कुछ नहीं पता है. So we know that these are the control signals that this control unit has to generate the moment it knows what is the instruction. So, matlab, if the control unit knows that move instruction has come, then immediately it has to start giving the details of move instruction. RY out has to come, RX in has to come, like this. If the instruction of add is coming, or if the instruction of subtraction is coming, automatically it should give you RY out, AN, RX out, BN, then add sub, then G out, then RX in. So all these things the control unit automatically has to give. Okay. So first thing is the control unit has to understand what is the instruction that I am getting. ठीक है? Because ये machine है, इसको कुछ नहीं पता है. हम लोग इसको नॉलेज बेस को अंदर डालना है, इसलिए वी हैव टू यूज सम काइंड ऑफ बाइनरी फंडामेंटल्स एंड बेसिकली डू दिस. सो नाउ दिस इज लाइक मेकिंग द हार्डवेयर. वी हैव टू मेक द हार्डवेयर नाउ टू सो दैट इट कैन केसली हैव अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट इज कमिंग टू. सो इन 8085 और एनी ऑफ दिस माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स दे यूज समथिंग कॉल्ड इंस्ट्रक्शन डिकोडर. ठीक है? तो अभी हमारे पास इंस्ट्रक्शन डिकोडर नहीं है. भी हमारे पास इंस्ट्रक्शन डिकोडर नहीं है. ठीक है? सो हाउ डू वी डू दिस? ठीक है, ये हमारा आप कोड है. Then what we need to do is we need to somehow convert this. The system should try to understand. The control unit should try to understand what are the instructions that I'm giving. Okay. So हम लोग अभी क्या है? अभी सारे blocks हैं. We have just simply made blocks. Now as a human we can understand what these blocks represent. What is the meaning of these blocks? But that is not the case for the machine. Machine doesn't understand anything. So we have to build hardware in each and every of this block. ओके okay. एक छोटा सा एग्जांपल मैं दे देता हूँ हाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड इंस्ट्रक्शन. ठीक है, सो मेरे पास चार इंस्ट्रक्शंस हैं. मेरा इंस्ट्रक्शन का नाम क्या है? I0, I1, I2 एंड I3. सही है? सो यू गॉट थ्री इंस्ट्रक्शंस, फोर इंस्ट्रक्शंस. I0, I1, I2, I3, वेयर I0 इज लोड, I1 इज मूव, I2 इज ऐड एंड I3 इज सबट्रैक्ट. ओके, नाउ my job is to basically make sure the control unit understands what is the meaning of these instructions. The control unit should understand what instruction I have got. So how will I do it? I'll give you one simple example. Okay, so mere paas opcode hai. Opcode mein first 2 bits I'm taking it. The first 2 bits only are instructions. Okay, so what we have decided earlier, I0, I1, I2, I3. So if it is 00, it is I0. 01, it is this thing. 10 is this thing. 11. Right? That's what we have seen before. Okay. So now what I will do is I'll make a simple multiplexer or 2x4 decoder. Okay, 1 2 3 4 1 2. So this is the input side, this is the output side. ठीक है, so अभी जो भी opcode का 2 bits है, this I will connect this to my instruction decoder or 2x4 decoder. Then if the instruction is I0, then this will be 1. If the instruction is I1, then this will be 1. If the instruction I2 is, this will be 1. And this is the instruction I3, this will be 1. Okay? So now what we have done is, now the this is before the control unit, or this will be part of control unit. This is like an instruction decoder. We are putting an instruction decoder. So in this instruction decoder, what happens is, so whichever gives you 1, then the control unit will understand, now I have got a load instruction, I've got a move instruction, and based on that then it has to generate sequence of control signals. So how to decide sequence of control signals? Then this is based on building sequential circuits. I don't know how many of you guys have read this. You can basically look for in Google what is sequential circuit. Sequential circuits is something where you are basically going to execute something in terms of sequence, and the block diagram of sequential circuits is something like this one. Okay, there are two types of sequential circuits. One is called Moore based sequential circuits, another is called Mealy based. I won't go into details because we don't have time. I want to take some examples today, but materials are available for all these things in books. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, so what will happen is, it will have some combinational logic circuits. Combinational logic circuits is basically your combination of gates. You can have NAND gate, NOR gate, AND gate, OR gate. All these gates will be the combination logic circuits. Then this will be communicating to flip-flops. Flip-flops are memory elements, and the output of this will again go into some combination logic circuits, and then you'll get an output. And this will be like a feedback system. Along with new inputs, okay, this is something like a similar block diagram. So thing is, this will help you to do anything in sequence. So because we have memory elements, so it will remember. So the moment you want to send R out, RX out, or RY out, then this will remember RY out is over. Next step is to basically do AN. Okay. So these are called sequential logic circuits. This is done using either Moore model or Mealy model. There are different advantages of using Moore model, different advantages of using Mealy model. All those things you can actually learn yourself because these are all available in books. Okay. So what we have done is we have now gone into this architecture. We're going into this architecture. Now I have a control unit. So I'm going inside this control unit. I'm basically making small hardwares inside the control unit. So I made an instruction decoder. Then I'll make one sequential circuit to make sure if this instruction comes, these are the sequence of signals that will go. That has to go along with clock because the sequential circuit itself is containing flip-flops, and flip-flops will work with clocks, right? So flip-flop always needs clock, right? So it always needs clock. Okay. So with this, I'm ending this topic, and then I'll move on to giving you some examples of how to build one embedded system. Okay. Any questions you guys have, you can type or you can unmute and ask before I move on. Next 1 hour or so, I think we'll focus on taking some simple example and see how to realize an embedded system. So what is the resolution of scientific calculator? I don't know what is the resolution of scientific calculator. It depends on what processor is inside. I seriously don't know what is the resolution of scientific calculator. Is there any way which we can change the clock speed of our processor? It depends on what is the speed at which you can do your work. For example, the addition that we are talking about. How fast you can basically make that addition depends upon what is the hardware you have in it. Okay, so it all depends on how they do the IC fabrication. If your adder is fast enough, then they will design the clock based on that fast, because they will try to make sure at least the operation is finished in one clock cycle, maximum operations. There are some operations which you cannot finish in one clock cycle, but they'll try to finish maximum operations in one clock cycle. Any other questions? Aap mic ko unmute karke baat kar sakte hain. Or at least you can type, at least I will know if you guys have understood or not. See, this, the entire processor, actually what we do is, what I do in my classes, we usually take this, we build the entire hardware. Ultimately, I'll explain what is FPGA, and people will take it up in FPGA and ultimately program it in the FPGA. Okay, wo actually wo 3 hafte, 4 hafte ka class hai. So wo aaj nahi cover kar sakta yahan pe. But I want to give you some overview of how to basically realize something in hardware and think from a hardware perspective. Ab log ka samajh aaya? Kuch doubts hai kya? Kuch respond kar lijiye, nahi hai to mujhe nahi pata hai. So are you able to hear my voice?
Yes, sir. We are able to hear you.
ठीक है ना? Okay. Any questions? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Sir, एक doubt था. हाँ. Sir, is there a way we can change the clock speed of our processor?
No, that's what I told. No. So the thing is, they will go by how fast you can do an operation. If let's say addition is my operation and I can finish it in 1 microseconds, then you cannot have a clock speed that is faster than 1 megahertz, right? But if the thing is, if let's say it takes 1 microseconds for doing one operation, the processor, they will give you some, let's say 500 kilohertz ka clock de diya, but they'll give you some options called PLL, phase locked loop. Okay, PLL is phase locked loop. Using PLL or phase locked loop, you can actually try to increase the clock frequency. This also they give you as an option. These are all coming from the manufacturer side, from the processor side.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other questions? So you can continue this and then take this for different you can try to build the hardware. The thing is, you have to build your own adder also, you have to build your own subtractor also. How will I build a subtractor? first I'll do a 2's complement. Then once I do a 2's complement, then I'll try to do an addition again. Because then I'll use less amount of hardware. If I use only the adder, then I'll use a 2's complement for the subtractor and then use the adder again. So in that way, I'll be able to do this addition subtraction ALU module. Similarly, everything has to come in terms of hardware. And then ultimately, if you know how to design this, then you'll get a very strong fundamental of how is the clock is working, how is the sequence circle circuit is working, how one after another goes. It's like that. Okay. So now I'll move on to taking up one simple application. Okay. We will take a simple application. First thing is to decide what is the specification of the application. So once we decide the specification of the application, then we will see how to basically bring it into an internet system frame. Okay. So I'll share my screen again. Okay. Naya page there again. Okay, so my application is going to be temperature sensing application. Okay. So we'll take a simple temperature sensing application. I hope many of you guys would have done projects using temperature sensing application. But here our approach is slightly different. Our approach is not to do the programming and find out the temperature. Our approach is to understand how to read data sheet. Temperature sensing is one single example. Tomorrow you can take any example and you should know how to read data sheet and how to design the embedded system. So our job here is to basically design the embedded system. तो पहले हम लोग रिक्वायरमेंट्स डिसाइड करेंगे. रिक्वायरमेंट्स क्या है? हमारा रिक्वायरमेंट्स क्या है? लेट्स से आई एम डिजाइनिंग अ टेंपरेचर टू मेंटेन अ टेंपरेचर इन अ बायोलॉजिकल इंक्यूबेटर. बायोलॉजिकल इंक्यूबेटर क्या होता है? तो हॉस्पिटल्स में बेबीज के लिए इफ अ न्यू बॉर्न बेबी वांट्स सम असिस्टेंस इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, in terms of carbon dioxide sending out, or in terms of temperature, they will keep the baby in a small biological incubator. The thing is, everything is controlled. In an outside environment, nothing is controlled. Temperature is varying from time to time. Oxygen content is varying time to time. Humidity is varying time to time. There, they want everything to be controlled because the baby wants a controlled environment so that the baby can grow properly. This is for very newborn babies or some premature babies. Okay? Isme kya kya hota hai? Biological incubator. Just one example I'm taking. क्या क्या होता है? ऑक्सीजन का कंटेंट करना चाहिए, टेम्परेचर का करना चाहिए. ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू टेक ओनली द टेम्परेचर पार्ट ऑफ इट. ओके, वी आर डिजाइनिंग ओनली फॉर टेम्परेचर पार्ट ऑफ इट. सिमिलरली यू कैन ट्राई डूइंग इट फॉर अदर थिंग्स योरसेल्फ. ओके, सो टेम्परेचर का कंट्रोल करना चाहिए. ओके, सो देन व्हाट आर ऑल द रिक्वायरमेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टेम्परेचर. ओके, वी विल डिसाइड, वी विल डिफाइन द रिक्वायरमेंट्स फर्स्ट. रिक्वायरमेंट्स आर गोइंग टू बी द टेम्परेचर हैज टू बी मॉनिटर्ड कंटिन्यूअसली बाय यूजिंग अ टेम्परेचर सेंसर. क्योंकि अंदर वो इंक्यूबेटर के अंदर क्या टेम्परेचर है वो कंटिन्यूसली मॉनिटर करना चाहिए. और मॉनिटर करने के लिए हम लोग एक एम्बेडेड सिस्टम बना दें. ठीक है, एक सिस्टम बना. ठीक है, तो इसका क्या क्या रेंज है? रेंज क्या है हम लोग का? रेंज क्या है? 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. ओके, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू वर्क फ्रॉम 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. दिस इज द रेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर दैट आई हैव टू मेजर. ये फर्स्ट रिक्वायरमेंट. सेकेंड रिक्वायरमेंट, व्हाट इज द रेजोल्यूशन? रेजोल्यूशन मतलब क्या है? हियर रेजोल्यूशन मींस, ठीक है, इफ लेट्स से आई यू आर आस्किंग मी व्हाट इज द टेंपरेचर इन योर हाउस टुडे, आई विल सिंपली रफली से इट इज अराउंड 25 degree Celsius. इफ आई एम गोइंग टू यूज अ एसी इन माय हाउस, एयर कंडीशनिंग सिस्टम इन माय हाउस, आई प्लेस इट एट 25 degrees इन माय एसी, देन इट कूल्स डाउन टू 25 degrees, देन ऑटोमेटिकली द कंप्रेसर स्टॉप्स. ओके, then again after some time when the cooling goes down, when the room is getting heated up, automatically the compressor switches on. What at what temperature it switches on? Maybe at 26 degrees, maybe at 27 degrees. It may not be so accurate because the requirement is not so accurate there. Okay, as long as it is cooling, as long as the cooling goes very low, then it switches on. So the requirement is not very accurate. But yahan pe ek bio incubator mein kya hai? Requirement is very accurate. If it goes for a very long temperature difference, then it's a big problem for us. So, yahan pe resolution hum log kya rakh denge? Resolution is going to be 1 degree Celsius. मतलब क्या है, 0 डिग्री से 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस होना है तो फिर I have to monitor a change of even 1 degree Celsius. If it is at 75 degrees Celsius, if it goes to 74 or if it goes to 76, then the temperature monitoring application should recognize that a change of 1 degree has happened. ये हमारा requirement. ठीक है, ठीक है. Third requirement क्या है? एक complete compact system होना चाहिए. इट्स अ जनरलाइज्ड रिक्वायरमेंट है. कॉम्पैक्ट सिस्टम होना चाहिए, इसलिए हम लोग एम्बेडेड सिस्टम करेंगे. ओके, फाइन. सो आई एम स्टॉपिंग माय स्क्रीन शेयर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू आस्क मी, देन वी विल मूव ऑन टू हाउ टू रियलाइज दिस सिस्टम. तो हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, एक सिंपल टेम्परेचर मॉनिटरिंग करना है बस. सो फॉर डूइंग अ सिंपल टेम्परेचर मॉनिटरिंग वी आर गोइंग टू टेक 3 रिक्वायरमेंट्स. फर्स्ट रिक्वायरमेंट इज द रेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर इज गोइंग टू बी फ्रॉम 0 डिग्रीज टू 100 डिग्रीज. सेकंड टेम्परेचर इज सेकंड रिक्वायरमेंट इज रेजोल्यूशन व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस. द थर्ड रिक्वायरमेंट, इट हैज बी अ कॉम्पैक्ट सिस्टम. ओके, एनी डाउट्स? नो डाउट्स. चलिए मूव अहेड. अभी आप लोग क्या करेंगे, यू कैन ऑल्सो स्टार्ट वर्किंग अलॉन्ग विद मी, बिकॉज आई ऑल्सो डोंट नो हाउ टू वर्क ऑन दिस. आई एम ऑल्सो गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट हाउ टू वर्क ऑन दिस. ओके, सो आई हैव टू, व्हाट आर ऑल द थिंग्स दैट आई नीड. ओके, लेट्स डिफाइन इट बेस्ड ऑन माय इजी अंडरस्टैंडिंग. आई वांट टू डिसाइड व्हाट आर ऑल द थिंग्स दैट आई नीड. सो ये एप्लीकेशन बनाना है, इसका फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी कॉल इट BOM. BOM इज बिल ऑफ मटेरियल. Bill of materials. So I want to understand what are all the things I need. Okay, we'll make it as a new page. Okay, bill of materials.
हाँ, अब एक सिंक क्या है अपने काल में.
Okay.
Hello. Please mute yourself. We request all the participants, please mute yourself. Dhananjay? Govind, please mute yourself.
मधुरिमा शॉर्ट कर सकते हैं. ठीक है, चलो वी स्टार्ट. ओके, सो वी लुक इनटू व्हाट आर ऑल द बिल ऑफ मटेरियल्स. ओके, this is my own personal understanding based on my own experience. You can choose some other components also, but this is just on a personal experience. I want to choose a temperature sensor first. So temperature sensor ka main kya hai, I have to look at 2 things. One is, can we have the range from 0 degrees to 100 degrees celsius. Second thing is, can I have 1 degree celsius resolution. सही है, ओके. सो वन सेंसर विच आई नो इज LM335 और LM35. ओके, फर्स्ट थिंग व्हाट आई विल डू, आई हैव टू गो इनटू द डेटा शीट ऑफ द LM35 एंड आई हैव टू फाइंड आउट वेदर दिस विल सैटिस्फाई दीस 2 क्राइटेरिया और नॉट. ओके, वी विल डू दैट, यू नो, इन अ वेरी शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम वी विल डू दैट. ओके, नेक्स्ट थिंग इज, सो मेरा छोटा सा ब्लॉक डायग्राम बना देंगे. एक छोटा सा टेम्परेचर सेंसर है, ओके इसका पावर सप्लाई चाहिए लेट्स से आई कॉल इट वीसीसी ठीक है इसका पावर दे दिया एंड देन इट विल बेसिकली इट इज केप्ट इनसाइड अ रूम ओके इंक्यूबेटर फॉर एग्जांपल सो इट विल चेक द टेंपरेचर एंड देन इट विल गिव यू एज एन आउटपुट ओके आउटपुट में लेक है since I want to make it as a compact system let's say I want to give it to an Arduino board theek hai Arduino board ye iska output kya hai iska output is going to be in terms of millivolts okay so matlab ye iska output kya hai iska output analog hai digital nahi hai okay iska output analog hai because as and when the temperature varies then the voltage as coming out as an output is also going to vary in an analog fashion which means that it is continuously going to change it is not going to be in digital format it is not going to be in 1 or 0 it is not possible okay it is being analog so naturally if I am going to use an Arduino board let's say I use Uno Arduino board then I'll have to connect to the ADC of Arduino board okay so I'll have to connect to the ADC of Arduino board so I'm going to modify this diagram So what we are going to do is we are going to give it to an ADC. Anyway, this ADC is present inside Arduino board. Okay, so I'll put a dot block. So what is ADC? ADC is analog to digital converter. For somebody who doesn't know, analog to digital converter because we have to convert everything to digital because any microcontroller or microprocessor is going to be a digital device. So what is happening in Arduino is Arduino itself contains one analog to digital converter so that you can connect your devices to this analog to digital converter sensors to this analog to digital converter to convert from analog to digital and then you can process it inside this Arduino so this is Arduino Uno board okay so I'm communicating this temperature sensors output to an ADC of the Arduino Uno and then ultimately then your Arduino Uno is going to collect the data it is going to collect the data and then using the collected data it will try to basically find out the temperature okay so this is a simple block diagram so my requirements are I have made three important things one is the ADC one is the Arduino microcontroller ATmega328P or let's say I call it Arduino board which contains ADC plus Arduino microcontroller and then you have a temperature sensor which I am going to use LM335 or it is popularly known as NM35 now okay my next step now is to basically go into LM335 in Google try to find the data sheet and try to understand whether it can give me a temperature range of 0 degrees to 100 degrees whether I can detect a change of 1 degrees and how do I set up this temperature sensor okay I have to set up this temperature sensor now we have to go into the circuitry of it how to build this temperature sensor if I buy this LM335 or LM35 from the market okay so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Google I'm going to search for the data sheet of LM335 and then I'm going to see the different parameters I also want you to do the same now you can actually go to your Google and basically try to get LM335 data sheet try to see whether you can get these requirements and also understand what is going to be the circuit diagram so we are going to do hum log saath mein karenge ठीक है आप लोग भी कर लीजिए मैं भी अभी कर रहा हूं सो LM335 इज अ टेक्सास इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स कंपनीज सेंसर सो आई हैव गॉट दिस LM335 इज दिस थिंग आई विल सी इफ आई कैन शो टू यू आल्सो Okay, now I have also got one LM335 sensor. Okay, so first thing is I will go into features. Okay, I am trying to explain to you how to read a data sheet. Okay, so I am going into features. So यहाँ पे second point क्या है? 1 degree Celsius initial accuracy available. So मेरा एक requirement है 1 degree Celsius का requirement है. That has been taken care of properly. Okay, Now we come here, the description. Okay, if I come to description, what it is saying, it is telling that LM135 series are precision easily calibrated integrated circuit temperature sensors operating as a two terminal Zener. The LM135 has a breakdown voltage directly proportional absolute temperature at 10 millivolts per degree Kelvin. Okay, with less than 1 ohm dynamic impedance, the device operates over a current range of 400 microampere to 5 milliampere. So इसका करंट रेंज क्या होना चाहिए? ये टेम्परेचर सेंसर रन करने के लिए करंट रेंज क्या होना चाहिए? इट शुड बी बिटवीन 400 माइक्रो एम्पियर टू 5 मिली एम्पियर. ओके, व्हेन कैलिब्रेटेड एट 25 डिग्री सेल्सियस, LM135 हैज टिपिकली लेस देन 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस एरर ओवर अ 100 डिग्री टेम्परेचर रेंज. सो अगेन यू हैव गॉट अ 100 डिग्री टेम्परेचर रेंज इज ऑल्सो गिवन हियर. सो यू कैन हैव दिस सेंसर. इन सेकंड पैराग्राफ, एप्लीकेशंस फॉर द LM35 इंक्लूड everything sensing over a range of minus 55 degree celsius to 150 degree celsius. So mera range kya hai? 0 to 100 degree celsius. So ye temperature sensor ye kaam kar sakta hai, theek hai. So I am coming back to my this thing. So the first requirement is I need to have a temperature sensor which has to sense from 0 to 100 degree celsius. Now I know that LM335 will be able to do this. Second thing is the resolution of my sensor has to be 1 degree Celsius. That is also known to me that it is possible to do this. ठीक है? So ये पहला वाला requirement है, वो satisfy हो गया. Now I have to go back and try to understand how to basically build the circuitry for this temperature sensor. Once we finish the temperature sensor, then I will come to the next step, which is going to be my ADC and Arduino. ठीक है? वो बाद में. तो पहला मैं इधर आ गया. तो ठीक है. सो यहाँ पे एक बेसिक टेम्परेचर सेंसर सिंप्लीफाइड स्कीमेटिक दे दिया. ओके, इफ आई कम टू द बॉटम ऑफ द फर्स्ट पेज इटसेल्फ, इन द लेफ्ट साइड आई कैन सी दैट आई कैन हैव द सिंबल ऑफ दिस LM335 इज लुकिंग लाइक अ ज़ीनर, एंड देन इट विल गिव यू आउटपुट इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट शुड हैव अ रेजिस्टेंस इन बिटवीन एंड इट विल गिव यू 10 मिलीवोल्ट पर डिग्री केल्विन. ओके, दिस इज व्हाट इज रिटन हियर. ओके, then I will go into the details of it. It will basically give you the different parameters, different specifications and all these things. Okay, now what I have to build is, I have to build this LM335 sensor circuitry first. Okay, what is 10 millivolt okay, so what is 10 millivolt per Kelvin? Okay, ठीक है. सो द थिंग इज दैट इज अ ब्रेकडाउन वोल्टेज. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज आई विल गो बैक टू द डेटा शीट एंड शो यू फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन विल सी. सी इट इज समथिंग लाइक अ ज़ीनर डायोड. ओके, सो इट इज समथिंग लाइक अ ज़ीनर डायोड. The thing is, it has a breakdown voltage directly proportional to absolute temperature at 10 millivolt per degree Kelvin. So when you are going to measure in terms of degree Kelvin, when it comes to the breakdown voltage, okay, it will give you a difference between 1 degree to next degree in terms of 10 millivolts. Okay, near the breakdown voltage. This is a Zener diode, so Zener diode will have its own breakdown voltage. So when it comes very close to the breakdown voltage, then the breakdown voltage will be proportional to the absolute temperature with the difference of around for every degree you'll have a 10 millivolts of difference. Okay, that's what we want to see. Okay, so okay, I'll go back to this thing. So let's build the circuitry for this thing. So as we have seen in this data sheet before, okay, so let's build this temperature sensor. So it's going to be LM335. Okay, are you guys able to see my writing now?
Yes sir, it's okay. Clear.
Okay, good. So this is going to be LM335. It's basically a 3 input pin sensor, but then let's not worry about the third pin right now. Okay, so then this is going to be VCC, I'm going to have one R. Second thing is you take the output from here. Okay. So if you go back and read the data sheet, I want to just cut the long story short. If you go back and read the data sheet, that this is basically like a transistor based temperature sensor. Okay. Like a BJT transistor based temperature sensor, where they look at this base and emitter junction. Okay. In base and emitter junction, what they try to do is they try to see how the temperature is going to basically vary. Okay. So when the temperature varies, naturally the base emitter voltage will also change. So this is actually equal to 2.2 millivolt per degree Celsius. Okay. For every degree Celsius of change, then it is going to take 2.2 millivolts. Okay. These are all available in data sheet. Okay. So anyway, that will come later. I just want to give you so that we cannot read everything in the data sheet here in the class. So I want to do this. Okay. Now what we need to do is I have to find out what is going to be my VCC and what is going to be my R. Okay. Why should I do this? Because this will switch on my temperature sensor and then it will start working. This will switch on my temperature sensor and the temperature sensor will start working. Then I have to calibrate this temperature sensor. So how to calibrate? You have to use some thermometer or something to calibrate whether the temperature sensor is working properly or not. If it is not calibrated, then we will not be able to use it in the system. Okay. So that's a step by step job to be done. Okay. ठीक है. So अभी हम लोग क्या करेंगे? VCC decide करना है, R decide करना. ठीक है. So we have decided that it is going to be a compact system. Okay. Compact system means I want this VCC to be taken care of by a battery. बैटरी से होगा तो अच्छा है बिकॉज देन इट कैन मेक श्योर इट इज अ कॉम्पैक्ट सिस्टम. सो बैटरी मीन्स आई कैन हैव बैटरीज ऑफ 9 वोल्ट्स, 12 वोल्ट्स, 3 वोल्ट्स, 6 वोल्ट्स. ओके. आई वुड प्रेफर टू चूज 9 वोल्ट्स और आई प्रेफर टू यूज 12 वोल्ट्स. बट इज दिस ओके विद द सेंसर और नॉट? आई हैव टू सी. हाउ विल आई सी इट? आई विल अगेन गो बैक टू द डेटा शीट. ओके. Okay, so I'll go back to data sheet. If I go to data sheet, then it has some something called maximum ratings, specified temperature, thermal information, thermal accuracy, electrical characteristics, operating output voltage change with respect to current. Okay, so they have not given me any voltage characteristics. Instead, what they have given me is they have given me the current characteristics. Okay, so for LM335 or LM335, I have to bother about my current characteristics. So how much of current that goes inside the sensor is what I have to take care of. Okay, so I'll stop the screen sharing. Can you guys type or can you guys unmute and tell me what is the current that has to go into this sensor? You can type it or you can actually unmute and speak also. Tell me what is the current that has to go inside this sensor. Where will I find this? I will find this only in the data sheet. Okay, somebody has written 1 milliampere. Is that correct? I also want to search. I'll also search. Only one person has said 1 milliampere. Any other answers? Is that correct? 400 microampere to 5 ampere. Okay. Okay, I'll share the screen. I'll show you the data sheet. I'll have to multiple share because one side I'm sharing my notebook, the other side I'm sharing my screen. So please bear with me. So now this is the data sheet. I hope you guys can see it. Now I am in section 6.2, recommended operating conditions. Okay, there I will basically so recommended operating conditions. Now there is something called forward current. Okay, what is the current that is going to go into this temperature sensor? It is called LM335. Okay, the forward current, it says that 0.4 minimum to maximum 5 milliampere. That is what one of the person has written, that it should be from 400 microampere to 500 microampere. So if it goes less than 400 microampere or if it goes more than 5 milliampere, then the temperature sensor will get damaged. Okay, so we have to, and then there is something called min, there is something called max, and in between min and max, there is something called nominal. Okay, nominal means what? This is the range which the factory guy is asking you to use. But then if there is a variation, the variation should be between 400 microampere and 5 milliampere. So here he says nominal value to be used is 1 milliampere. That's why the other student has written 1 milliampere, which is actually correct. Okay, so for forward current, it has to be used at 1 milliampere. Okay, now I'll go back to my my notes. Okay, I go back to my notes where I want to make sure that I choose any voltage. So let's say I choose a 9-volt battery. So I'll again redraw this. Okay, so let's say I choose a 9-volt battery. Let's redraw this. Okay, so I have 9-volt. Then I have a resistance, then I have this temperature sensor, LM335. This is 9-volt, this is going to be resistance, and this is going to be my output. Okay, so how will I find out what is going to be the current that is going through? Then I'll do V is equal to IR. Okay, so 9 divided by my 1 milliampere is equal to R. So this is how much? This is going to give me 9k is equal to R. Okay, there is no 9k available, so I'll use either 7.8k or I'll use 8.8k or I'll use 10k resistance. Okay, so this will decide what is the current that is actually going inside my temperature sensor. So as long as the current going inside the temperature is approximately 1 milliampere, I know this temperature sensor will work properly. Okay. Okay. After getting the data sheet, then I realized that my requirements are a little on the easy side. So let's make the question a little difficult. So I'll go back to my requirements. Okay. So kindly bear with me. I'm going to confuse you, but I'm going back to my requirements now. My requirements is, I think it's in the previous page. Okay. I'll go back to my requirements. My resolution, I said that I want to basically monitor in terms of 1 degree Celsius. Okay, let's make it a little more difficult. Okay, 1 degree Celsius is also fine, but then let's make it a little more difficult. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this as, we want to make this as 0.5 degree Celsius. Okay, so 0.5 degree Celsius, is it possible? It's still possible because this temperature sensor actually, I'm making it 0.5 degree Celsius because the temperature sensor actually says 10 millivolts per degree Celsius, right? So for every change in 1 degree, it will have a change of 10 millivolts. So if there is a change of 0.5 degree Celsius, then it will have 5 millivolts of difference. The output will be of 5 millivolts of difference. Okay. So I'm changing this question slightly. The reason is I want the question to be a little more tougher so that I'll explain what will happen when we go into Arduino Uno. Okay. So that's the reason I've done this. Okay. So now we have come to this battery. So now we have finalized one single set of it. Okay. So we had a block diagram. We had a block diagram. In the block diagram, what we had is we had the temperature sensor, right? The temperature sensor part is over now. This we have completed. Okay. What we have done is we have put a VCC and then we had a resistor. Then we had this temperature sensor and this is the output that is taken out. Okay. So now we have chosen this to be 9.8K or something. and then this will be 9 volts. The 9 volts, the reason I chose 9 volts is basically to have a battery. If I have a power supply, if I want to keep it in a compact manner, then I'll choose something like 12 volts or 15 volts. Okay. So it is mainly I've chosen 9 volts because I want to have a battery integrated system. Okay. Now the output of it is going to be in terms of millivolts. Okay. The output from the temperature sensor is going to be millivolts. Now let's also define this. Now what happens is, for every 1 degree Celsius, you're going to have 10 millivolts of difference. Okay. So if let's say it is going to show you 22 millivolts now at some temperature. Okay. Then what will happen is, if there is going to be a change in temperature, let's say the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, then if it becomes 26 degrees Celsius, then you will basically have 32 millivolts. That is the meaning of having 1 degree Celsius, you have a 10 millivolts of difference. Okay. Now the resolution that we want to detect is every 5 millivolts we want to detect. And that is possible using this, we have seen from the data sheet. Okay. Now the next step is to basically use a Arduino Uno board. Or to be very specific, what we want to do is, we want to look at what is going to be the specifications of my ADC present in the Arduino Uno board. Okay. So can you guys go and search for the data sheet of Arduino Uno and look at what is the specification of the ADC or analog to digital converter? Can you guys do it? I'll also do it now. For 2 minutes, if you guys have any questions, you guys can search for it. If you guys have any questions, you can tell me. You can message me in this chat box, or you can unmute and speak before we move on to the next step. Meanwhile, you can actually search for the data sheet of Arduino.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
What was your question?
My question is, now we had 3 parts. Ek temperature sensor ka part tha, aur ek Arduino mein ek ADC ka part hai. Theek hai? So abhi temperature sensor ka finalize kiya hai.
Yes,
abhi
sir.
Next step is to basically understand what is the specification of the ADC present in Arduino Uno. कुछ डाउट्स है क्या?
सर, as far I can see,
any questions from audience? You know, other people can also type also. You tell me.
It can detect to power 10 discrete analog level.
हाँ, ठीक है. Good. I'll wait for 2-3 minutes. Let other people also look into this. Okay. Yeah. Any other person who has any questions, you can tell me. You can type also.
सर, Arduino Uno की डेटा शीट सर्च कर रहा हूँ तो उसमें पार्ट नंबर में 80 मेगा 328 आ रहा है और 328 बी भी आ रहा है. सर, इसमें क्या डिफरेंस रहता है?
सी, ये बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस आ जाएगा आपको. तो सारे क्वेश्चंस के लिए मैं आंसर दे दूंगा तो फिर यू विल नॉट लर्न एनीथिंग. सो आप लोग सर्च कर सकते हैं क्या? डायरेक्टली सर्च व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीस टू.
ओके सर,
यू सर्च एंड फाइंड आउट. सो 8 मेगा 328, ठीक है? तो मैं मेरा स्क्रीन तो शेयर कर रहा हूँ. आई विल आल्सो सर्च लाइक हाउ यू गाइस आर सर्चिंग. ठीक है, एलएम 335 डेटा शीट तो हो गया. देन आई मूविंग ऑन टू 8 मेगा 328. आई एम आल्सो सर्चिंग इन गूगल. ठीक है, 8 मेगा 338 पी. इट इज बेसिकली फ्रॉम एटमल. आई थिंक नाउ एटमल इज बीन बॉट बाय माइक्रोचिप. इट्स एन एटमल कंपनी. I think Microchip, which is PIC company, has bought this. ठीक है, अभी क्या है? ये 8 मेगा 328 पी है. I'll also search in Arduino Uno. ठीक है, I'll go to Arduino Uno also. Double check that Arduino Uno actually contains 8 मेगा 328. ठीक है, so Arduino Uno है. इसमें क्या है? इसका technical specification है. Technical specification में 5 volts. 8 मेगा 328 पी यूज कर रहा है. ठीक है, 8 मेगा 328 पी में क्लिक करेंगे तो फिर इसका डेटा शीट आ जाएगा ऑटोमेटिकली. ठीक है, आई हैव गॉन इनटू आर्डिनो that's from Arduino. I'm looking into Atmega 328. Okay? So Atmega 328 mein bahut sare options hai, ye hai, PA hai, kya farak hai? That's a question that you ask, no? You come back to data sheet, you will understand what is the difference. There are some minute differences. The family is still the same. There can be some minute differences which people will write in the data sheet. Okay? I'll give you some place where there are some examples. Resources mein dekhenge. Yeah? See, the architecture is same. Architecture is something similar to what we have built, because this is a microcontroller now. Now you can appreciate what is an architecture. If they have used a program counter, they have used status and control unit, interrupts, SPI, all these are communication models, instruction decoder unlock bhi kiya hai, aur flash program memory hai, ALU hai, aur different IO lines hai. Theek hai? So how will I show you what is the difference, no? You see now. See, what are all the different Atmega 328P? There are several Atmega 328. What is this? What is the difference in this? So you see, the memory is different here. So depending upon what is the variable that they are using, based on that, the memory is different. You see here, one is 4 kilobytes, one is 8 kilobytes, one is 16, one is 32. So based on that, the configuration will change. But the family is the same. If you know how to work on one family, then you can work on the same family anywhere. Okay? So, अभी मेरे पास कहाँ जाना है? मैं एडीसी के पास जाना है. एडीसी कहाँ है? टाइमर है, पोर्ट्स है, एक्शन इंटरफेस है, यूजर है. अनलॉक टू डिजिटल कन्वर्टर सेक्शन 24. तो अनलॉक टू डिजिटल कन्वर्टर है. इसका 10 बिट रेजोल्यूशन है. 10 बिट रेजोल्यूशन मतलब क्या है? इट हैज 10 पिंस. ओके, so if the analog input is a one single pin, if the analog input is one single pin, so it will basically contain 10 bits on the output side. So if you take a ADC as a block, the input is one single pin, because it's an analog signal coming from your temperature sensor which will be connected to this. The output will give you 10 different pins. So like in our processor, we decided a 4-bit thing, so it will have 4 ones and zeros. So a number can be 1010, 1111, 0000, 0101, 01111, like this. Similarly, here it will have 10 bits. So the resolution of my ADC is going to be 10 bits. Here we are not bothered about speed, so I don't care about speed right now. But the thing is, the resolution is 10 bits means, what is the meaning of this? Okay. So the resolution is 10 bits means, it means that, I'll come back to my notebook. Okay, so resolution 10 bits matlab, it is going to take 10 different values. Okay, resolution of my ADC is 10 bits. So what do you mean by 10 bits? हम लोग एक छोटा सा simple example ले लेंगे, ठीक है? Let's say resolution of another ADC, some other ADC, let's say it's 2 bits. Okay, so resolution is 2 bits means, then what will happen? It can take basically 2 bits. Okay, so what are all the values that this ADC can take? It can take 00, 01, 10, 11, because resolution is only 2 bits. So it can take 4 values. Okay, so iska VCC kya hai? So what is the range of this ADC? That also we have to see. Okay, let's say the range is from 0 to 5 volts. Okay, for this I'm talking about not Arduino ADC. I'm simply taking one hypothetical example. Ek chota sa example le lenge, so that we can understand and appreciate what is the meaning of this ADC. Then we'll come back and basically look into our Arduino ADC again. Okay, abhi main ek chota sa ADC le raha hu, wo iska resolution hai 2 bits. Okay, 2 bits resolution matlab iska 4 values ho sakta hai, 00, 01, 10, 11. Theek hai? इसका रेंज क्या है 0 to 5 volts, मतलब क्या है द एंटायर 5 volts इट विल बी डिवाइडेड बाय 4 different values. Okay, let's say it is 4 volts. Life becomes a little easy for me. Okay, let's say it is 4 volts and become 4 by 4 is equal to 1, which means what? Any value that is coming to my ADC, this is my ADC, an analog input is coming to me. It will generate 4 different pins, and it will be sorry. I made a mistake. It will give you 2 pins because the 2-bit resolution. So 2-bit resolution. So इसका 2-bit में एक 00 हो सकता है, 01 हो सकता है, 10 हो सकता है, 11 हो सकता है. मतलब the range is going to be between 1 volt. So if the input is coming to be 0.5 volt, what will be the output? It will give you 00 only, or it will give you 1 volt only. Okay, the input is going to give me 1 volt. It will again give you 00, 1 volt only. Okay, the input is going to be 1.5 volt. It will give you what? It will give you 2 volt signal, which is 01. Okay, and 2 volts, it will give you 01. So if it is 1.2 volts, will it be giving something? It won't give you anything. It will again give you the same as this. So the thing is, it has a range of this. This was 00, this was 01, this was 10, this was 11. So then this will be representing 1 volt, this will be representing 2 volts, this will be representing 3 volts, this will be representing 4 volts. Okay. So, मतलब क्या है, जो भी 1 volt और 2 volt के बीच में जो भी हो रहा है, it will not be able to resolve them. It will not be able to give you the difference between 1.2 volts and 1.3 volts. It will anything more than 1 volt only it can detect. समझ आया? It will only detect anything more than 1 volt. So why the problem is because the resolution is very small, because the number of bits is very small. ठीक है? ये कैसे connect किया है? ये 4 कैसे आ गया? So it is basically 2-bit resolution. So I will basically calculate 2 power 2 is equal to 4. Okay, now हम लोग अभी Arduino का ADC के पास आ जाएंगे. So Arduino का ADC क्या है? It is going to basically have 10 bits. So 2 power 10, which is going to be 1024. Okay, if I use 0 volt also as one signal, then I'll have 1023 values. Okay, samajh aaya? Any doubts? Any doubts? No. Ye ek important concept hai.
सर जो इनपुट से एनालॉग से आ रहा है करंट, आई मीन सॉरी वोल्टेज, वो जितना ही पिन होगा उसमें डिवाइड हो जाएगा?
नहीं सर, एक ही पिन है. एडीसी का प्रिंसिपल क्या है? इनपुट एक ही पिन है, एनालॉग पिन है.
हाँ
ठीक है, वो एनालॉग वोल्टेज लेके वो एक्चुअली डिजिटल सिग्नल्स कन्वर्ट कर रहा है.
ओके सर, तो
ठीक है, जो भी कन्वर्शन हो रहा है, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द नंबर ऑफ बिट्स. ठीक है,
वोल्ट कैसे डिवाइड हो रहा है पिंस में, आउटपुट पिंस में वोल्ट कैसे डिवाइड हो रहा
है? ओके, आई विल एक्सप्लेन अगेन. आई विल टेक वन न्यू पेज. द थिंग इज, लेट्स से आई टेक एन एडीसी टू बिट्स. ठीक है, सो टू बिट्स मतलब इसका ब्लॉक डायग्राम क्या होता है? एडीसी है, इनपुट है, इनपुट एनालॉग पिन है, सिर्फ एक ही पिन है. सो व्हाट इज द जॉब ऑफ एडीसी? इट विल टेक इन व्हाटएवर इनपुट दैट इज कमिंग इनटू दिस एनालॉग पिन, इट विल कन्वर्ट इनटू डिजिटल विद रिस्पेक्ट टू क्लॉक. ओके, सो द थिंग इज कंटीन्यूअसली सम सिग्नल, लेट्स से वी टेक सम साइनसॉइडल सिग्नल, कंटीन्यूअसली सम सिग्नल इज ऑलवेज कमिंग. ओके, दिस सिग्नल हैज टू बी कन्वर्टेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिजिटल. हाउ इट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिजिटल? फॉर एग्जांपल, लेट्स से दिस इज 0 वोल्ट, let's say this is 1 volt, let's say this is 1.5 volt, 1.5, let's say it is 2 volts. This is 3 volts. Okay, so how will I convert this? How this ADC is actually converting? It will convert in terms of ranges. It will make ranges. ये कितना रेंज कर सकते हैं इसका रेजोल्यूशन की डिपेंड करता है. ठीक है, अभी मेरा ADC क्या क्या है, सिर्फ 2 बिट्स है, तो फिर इसका ओनली 2 रेंज हो सकता है, एक नीचे और एक ऊपर बस. सॉरी, इट कैन हैव 2 पावर 2 इज इक्वल टू 4 रेंजेस, सो 1 2 3 4 4 रेंज हो सकता है. सो एनीथिंग इन बिटवीन दिस रेंज विल बी काउंटेड आइदर ऑन हियर और हियर. सो एनीथिंग इन बिटवीन दिस रेंज इट विल आइदर गो हियर और इट विल गो हियर. That depends upon the manufacturer's settings, because the range is like this. Okay?
Okay, sir. Now I got it.
So now the thing is, now in our case, in our own Arduino ADC, we have got 10-bit resolution, 2 power 10. That is equal to 1024. Okay. But then I want to use 0 volts also as a count, because we want to use 0 degree Celsius, right? So then my range is going to be from 0 to 1023 values. ठीक है, एनी क्वेश्चंस, एनी डाउट्स? इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस यू टेल मी, देन वी मूव ऑन.
सर, कैन वी कैलकुलेट द नेगेटिव टेंपरेचर?
दैट्स अ गुड क्वेश्चन. एक्चुअली कैन वी कैलकुलेट द नेगेटिव टेंपरेचर? सो द थिंग इज, व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज यू हैव टू चेक वेदर योर एडीसी एक्चुअली हैज कैन टेक नेगेटिव वैल्यूज ऑर नॉट. यूजुअली मोस्ट ऑफ द एडीसीज विल नॉट बी एबल टू टेक नेगेटिव वैल्यूज. देन व्हाट वी शुड बी डू, then we have to give one offset. For example, hamara voltage, analog voltage aa raha hai -2 volts, minimum voltage, maximum minimum voltage kya ho raha hai, -2 millivolts. Then main kya karunga, main -2 millivolts ka offset de dunga, pehle aise ek dc offset de dunga, so that everything becomes positive. Fir Arduino mein aur jo bhi microcontroller hai iske andar jo bhi hum log calculate karna hai, wahan pe I will try to minus the offset and make it as negative. Any other questions? 10:30 हो रहा है, अंदर 15 minutes कर लेंगे, फिर थोड़ा सा आप लोगों का थोड़ा सा examples दे दूँगा. ठीक है? Any questions? Any doubts? आप take कर सकते हो. नहीं है? जा सकते हैं? Okay, ठीक है. Okay. So now I'll go back to 1023 So 1023 value is ka range kya hai, then I have to again go back to data sheet. I have to go to data sheet and then I have to go and see what is going to be the range of my ADC. So iska range kya hai? So I have come to my ADC. It's a 10 bit resolution. They are giving me conversion time up to 6 multiplexer input channels. Okay, 0 to VCC. So they have given that your voltage range is going to be 0 to VCC. So what is 0 to VCC in Arduino? You know, I think the VCC is 3.3 volts. You can double check if I'm wrong. I think more or less it's correct. So the Arduino Uno's VCC is 3.3 volts. So main abhi kya karunga? So I'll go back here. I'll see. So I have 1023 values. 1023 values are there. ठीक है? My range is going to be 3.3 divided by 1023 volts. Okay, so this will tell me what is the resolution of every range. यहाँ पे हम लोग क्या किया है? Same चीज हम लोग किया है. 4 bits, 2 bits था, इसलिए 4 range था. So इसका range कैसे calculate किया है? If it is going to be 0 to 1 volt, then the 1 volt was a range. So we are also trying to find out what is the range. ये रेंज क्यों कैलकुलेट करना है? वेदर आवर टेम्परेचर सेंसर्स आउटपुट, इफ इट इज गोइंग टू गिव इट टू अस, इफ इट इज गोइंग टू गिव इन टर्म्स ऑफ 10 मिलीवोल्ट्स पर डिफरेंस, नॉट 10 मिलीवोल्ट्स पर डिग्री सेल्सियस, आई वांट टू मॉनिटर एवरी 0.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस. दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव डन द रिक्वायरमेंट. सो 0.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस मतलब 5 मिलीवोल्ट्स का डिफरेंस मुझे चाहिए. 5 मिलीवोल्ट्स का डिफरेंस ये दे देगा नहीं दे देगा एडीसी, इसलिए वी आर ट्राइंग टू बेसिकली कैलकुलेट. ठीक है, so I'm going to open my calculator. आप लोग भी calculate कर लीजिए. What is going to be my this thing? So my calculator is going to tell me 3.3 divided by 1023. Okay, that is going to be 3.2222 something. So otherwise it is going to be 3.2 millivolts. Okay, am I correct? If I made any mistake, you guys can tell me. ठीक है? So अभी ये क्या हो रहा है, दिस 3.3 divided by 1023 is going to give me 3.22 millivolts, which means what? Anything between 0 to 3.22 millivolt, it will always represent as 0000000000. I have put 10 bits, okay, because it's a 10 bit resolution, okay. So, abhi kya hoga? 3.22 say next, which is going to be, let's say, 6.44 millivolts. Mera next range hai. A range mein aapko ADC mein kya values milega? 0000000001. It will move on to the next decimal single. Okay. So anything in between 0 to 3.22 millivolts will always get 0. Anything in between 3.22 millivolts to 6.44 millivolts, you will always get 0000001. Okay, which means what I am trying to tell you is the resolution of my ADC in Arduino in this case is going to be 3.22 millivolts. Now, we will go to the requirement. What is our requirements block design? We have to decide 0.5 degree Celsius of resolution, which means what I will get, I have to monitor a change of 0.5 millivolts. And my ADC will not be able to do it. समझ आया? मेरा ADC ये नहीं कर सकता है. क्यों नहीं कर सकता है? क्योंकि ADC का resolution के हिसाब से इसका range का resolution है 3.22 millivolts. लेकिन मुझे चाहिए 0.5 millivolts, वो नहीं मिल सकता है. समझ आया?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है. Any other questions? अभी क्या करना है फिर? इसीलिए हम लोग एक एम्बेडेड सिस्टम डिजाइन कर रहे हैं. सो एम्बेडेड सिस्टम मतलब सिर्फ एक टेम्परेचर सेंसर लेके सिर्फ एक माइक्रो कंट्रोलर में डाल के फिर प्रोग्राम करना है, एम्बेडेड सिस्टम नहीं है. ये सारे डिजाइन हम लोग करना है. सो हम लोग वी आर डिजाइनिंग दिस सिस्टम. सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग इज नाउ अगेन आई विल कम बैक टू सॉरी 9 वोल्ट्स. सो आई हैव अ रेसिस्टर, देन आई हैव माय टेम्परेचर सेंसर एंड दिस विल कम अप. नाउ द प्रॉब्लम इज आई हैव एन एडीसी हियर. I'm separating ADC and microcontroller just for my own understanding. ठीक है? So ADC है, ADC का 10 bit resolution है, लेकिन इसका resolution actually 3.2 millivolts है. मेरा यहाँ पे resolution आ रहा है 0.5 millivolts को चाहिए. ठीक है? Actually 0.1 millivolts का resolution आ जाएगा, लेकिन 0.5 millivolts का difference चाहिए मुझे. यहाँ पे 3.2 millivolts है. So हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं? We are stuck ना. So I'm going to design something in between, which I call it AFE, which is called analog front end. Analog front end kya hota hai? I'm going to make a simple analog front end, which is going to take these analog sensors input. It will make modifications such that the same resolution can be achieved and that can be given to ADC. ठीक है, वो कैसे कर सकते हैं? वेरी सिंपल. नाउ द थिंग इज द रेजोल्यूशन दैट आई हैव हियर इज 3.2 मिलीवोल्ट्स. ठीक है, सो मैं 0.5 मिलीवोल्ट्स का डिफरेंस है, रेजोल्यूशन है, वो 3.2 मिलीवोल्ट्स का मैच करना है. कैसे मैच करेंगे? 3.2 मिलीवोल्ट्स डिवाइडेड बाय 0.5 मिलीवोल्ट्स, और इट्स एक्चुअली हाफ, राइट? सो इट्स एक्चुअली हाफ मिलीवोल्ट. This will become 6.4 millivolt. ठीक है? Or in other sense, 0.5 millivolts. I have to convert this into 6.4 millivolts. ठीक है? मतलब क्या है? I have to give a 3 times amplification. So I'll take a simple temperature sensor output. What I will do now is I will basically try to build one amplifier. 9 volt ka ye hai. Basically take this. What I will do, op-amp, you would have at least had some basics, I guess. somebody who doesn't have any basics, I'm very sorry because I'm going in some continuation. You can look at what is an op-amp amplifier, and then you can Google it and find out, or you can actually refer to any electronics book which will contain op-amp amplifier, or you can use a BJT amplifier also, whatever you are convenient with. I'm simply using op-amp because it's easy for me. So this is RI, this is RF, and the output of it will basically give me. So the amplification of this is going to be, amplification of this op-amp is going to be minus RF by RI is my amplification. Okay? अभी क्या है ये नेगेटिव हो गया सो क्या है मैं एक्चुअली क्या चूज करूंगा आई विल चूज दिस एज 300k आई विल चूज दिस एज 100k ओके ठीक है एक 300k हो गया 100k हो गया फिर क्या होगा जो भी इनपुट है यहां पे आउटपुट में 3x टाइम्स 3 टाइम्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन हो गया ठीक है बट ओनली प्रॉब्लम इज नाउ इट हैज बिकम नेगेटिव नाउ समबडी आस्क्ड मी अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन इफ इट इज नेगेटिव देन हाउ विल आई हैंडल हाउ विल माय एडीसी हैंडल आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू हैंडल माय एडीसी डजंट नो हाउ टू हैंडल तो मैं एक और चीज करूंगा एक और ऑप एम्प में डाल दूंगा ठीक है यहाँ पे स्पेस नहीं है बट आई कीप आरएफ टू आरआई टू ठीक है आई कीप आरएफ टू इज इक्वल टू आरआई टू सो इट इज सिंपली लाइक वर्किंग एज अ बफर सो इसका आउटपुट क्या होगा इसका आउटपुट विल बी दिस इज माइनस 3x इसका आउटपुट 3x आ जाएगा वापस Okay, so whenever there is a change of 0.5 millivolts, it will be multiplied by 3. Sorry, I made a mistake. I have to multiply by 6. Sorry. See, the thing is, I need to get one, difference of 6. It has to bring it to 3.2 millivolts, right? So it has to multiply by 6. So let's say I use 600K here. So this will give you minus 6x. This will give you plus 6x. And then here 0.5 into 6, this will give me 3 millivolts. Okay? So every 0.5 ka change hai, first 0.5, 0 to 0.5 millivolts, it will be 3 millivolts. Or 0.5 to 1 millivolt ka change hai, it will give me 6 millivolts. Okay? So then what happens is, I have made an analog front end and converted this range to the range of the ADC. Okay? समझ आया सो आई विल अगेन ड्रॉ द ब्लॉक डायग्राम वी हैव अ टेम्परेचर सेंसर वी हैव कनेक्टेड इट देन वी आर गोइंग टू गिव इट टू अ एएफई और एन एनालॉग फ्रंट एंड द आउटपुट ऑफ दिस विल गो इनटू माय एडीसी ऑफ माय आर्डिनो अल्टीमेटली इट विल गो टू माय एटमेगा म्यूजिक ओके दिस इज अ कंप्लीट एम्बेडेड सिस्टम सो दिस इज आई हैव डन द हार्डवेयर पार्ट The rest of the part is going to be programming in the software, how to acquire this data and how to use this data to display something. For example, you want to display this temperature to the outside user. So then you can do it. But now we have converted the resolution of it by adding an analog front end. We looked into the data sheet of temperature sensor and understood how to basically understand the data sheet and how to build the circuitry for building the temperature sensor. Okay, more or less I have done it. Any questions?
All clear, sir.
Huh. Okay, good. Any other questions? You can write a text message here also. No questions. So could it be possible that amplification of negative temperature match with positive temperature? मतलब क्या actually I didn't understand the question. What is the question? I don't understand.
Means sir, अगर negative temperature रहता है, तो उसका जो input होगा जो भी वो क्या कहते हैं करंट सप्लाई करेगा वो तो नेगेटिव में रहेगा तो उसको एम्पलीफाई करेगा माइनस 6x से तो वो पॉसिबल ही है कि वो
नहीं फिर हम लोग ऑफसेट दे देंगे ना एडीसी के पहले हम लोग ऑफसेट दे देंगे.
ओके मतलब ऑफसेट लगेगा ही.
ऑफसेट देना ही. इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सी आई एम हियर माय रेंज इज ओनली फ्रॉम 0 टू 100 नो सो एवरीथिंग इज पॉजिटिव सो आई डोंट दैट्स व्हाई आई एम नॉट गिविंग ऑफसेट बट द मोमेंट योर रेंज इज बिटवीन कमिंग इनटू नेगेटिव देन यू हैव टू गिव अ पर्टिकुलर ऑफसेट वो भी सिस्टम में ऐड करना पड़ेगा.
ओके थैंक यू.
तो वो एनालॉग फ्रंट एंड में पहला वाला ऑप एम्प है ना वहां पे आप ऑफसेट दे सकते हैं.
ओके
ठीक है. सो नाउ आई विल गिव यू वन सिंपल हिंट ऑफ हाउ टू डू इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स. नाउ ये जो भी टेम्परेचर है वो टेम्परेचर एम्बेडेड सिस्टम में एक माइक्रो कंट्रोलर वहां पे मॉनिटर कर रहा है. ठीक है. इट इज प्रॉपरली मॉनिटरिंग द टेम्परेचर. इट इज रिकॉर्डिंग इट. मे बी यू कैन डिस्प्ले इट. नाउ ये डिस्प्ले अगर ये डिस्प्ले लेट्स से 25 डिग्रीज इज अ नॉर्मल. अगर इफ इट गोज मोर देन 30 डिग्रीज कैन यू सेंड दिस वैल्यू एज एन अलार्म टू अ यूजर थ्रू SMS. Can we send an alarm to the user through SMS? Or can you send an alarm to some other device, which will basically try to alert somebody? So then what will happen is you are bringing in Internet of Things into picture. Okay.
Yes, sir, अपन कर सकते हैं उसको वाईफाई से या फिर इंटरनेट कनेक्शन के थ्रू.
हाँ हाँ वो आईओटी का एप्लीकेशन हो जाएगा.
एमसीयू सर्किट जो होता है उससे इसी के लिए होता है ना वाईफाई कनेक्शन के.
There are some MCUs which contains Wi-Fi, and if you have internet, then you can connect it to it. And if you don't have internet, then you have to buy one GSM model. So there are some GSM models. So हमारा फोन में क्या है? हमारा फोन में एक प्रोसेसर है और वो प्रोसेसर एक छोटा सा सिम कार्ड को कनेक्ट करके फिर वो सिम कार्ड का डेटा यूज करके वो इंटरनेट भेज रहा है मोबाइल डेटा में. सो वी हैव टू डू विद GSM मॉड्यूल और विद मोबाइल फोन मॉड्यूल. ओके नाउ आई गिव यू वन एक्सरसाइज. विद डैट आई वॉन्ट टू कंक्लूड द क्लास बिकॉज इज ऑलमोस्ट 10:45 नाउ. ओके द एक्सरसाइज इज अभी हम लोग आर्डिनो देखा था. आर्डिनो में क्या है एक एटमेगा 328P है. इसका स्पेसिफिकेशन देख के हम लोग एक छोटा सा सिस्टम बनाया. ठीक है ये तो हो गया. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज टू बेसिकली लुक एट इफ लेट्स से आई डोंट वांट टू बाई एन आर्डिनो बोर्ड. आई डोंट वांट टू बाई अ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर बोर्ड. आई सिंपली वांट टू बाई ओनली माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. विल आई बी एबल टू बिल्ड माई ओन बोर्ड और नॉट? दैट्स अ क्वेश्चन. Okay, will I be able to build my own board or not? Okay, for that I want to use some other microcontroller. I don't want to use Arduino just because to give some variety so that other microcontrollers also you will understand what it is. Okay, so my microcontroller that I want to use is STM32. I'll write down. Okay, so that you guys can see it. Okay, so we'll go into next page. My microcontroller that I want to use is STM32F042F6. This is one more microcontroller manufactured by a company called ST Microelectronics. This is one company. So something like Atmel, something like Intel, there is one more company called ST Microelectronics, which is manufacturing a microcontroller called STM32F04256. Will I be able to just purchase only the microcontroller IC chip? I want to purchase only the microcontroller IC chip and I want to build my own board. Similarly, the same question can be asked. Can I buy only Atmega 328 chip? And can I build my own Arduino board myself? Is it possible to do it? Can you guys go into the data sheet of STM32F04256 and tell me whether it is possible or not? I'll give you 5 minutes. Quickly, there is power cut here. I'll switch on my lights and come back. but you guys go to the data sheet and quickly tell me whether STM32F402F6 can be performed or not.
Yes, sir. We are on it.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
So STM32F04256 se kuch ho sakta hai? Is it possible to basically do this? No, you're not understanding. See, abhi hum log kya kiya hai, hum log ek Arduino board leke kiya hai. What is that Arduino board? It contains lot of things in the board. But the most important brain of that board is the processor, which is Atmega 328. My question is, if I just buy the IC of Atmega 328, which contains the microcontroller, including ADC, can I build the rest of the things? Can I build a programmer? Can I build a small board? How do I build this? Can we build by reading the data sheet is the question. Question samajh aaya? Possible or not? Can you go to the data sheet of that STM F042F6 and tell me if it is possible? Please repeat question. Okay, ठीक है. So ठीक है मैं क्या करूँ? Okay, I'll show how does it. ठीक है, I'll share some Google links. ठीक है, मैं अभी गूगल में जाके आर्डिनो बोर्ड किया है. ठीक है, आर्डिनो बोर्ड मतलब इट इज गिविंग मी व्हाट आर ऑल द आर्डिनो बोर्ड्स अवेलेबल. ये एक बोर्ड में क्लिक कर रहा हूँ. ठीक है, इसका इमेज मेरे पास आ गया. ओके, सो ये मेरा आर्डिनो बोर्ड है. ठीक है, ये बोर्ड में क्या है, एट द एंड देयर आर आईओस एंड देन देयर आर सम पिंस. And then in the, now you can see that there is one IC, and this IC, if you go and read properly, it is written on an inverted side. It is written as Atmega 328P. Okay, it is written in an inverted fashion. What is this? This is my microcontroller in this board. ठीक है, मेरा question क्या है, ये board कितना रुपया का है? अभी यहाँ पे 594 बोल रहा है. ठीक है, Amazon में सिर्फ मैं Google किया है, 594 बोल रहे हैं. और इसका चिप का, ये Atmega 328P का आईसी का चिप का कितना पैसा है? This will cost you hardly 35 रुपीस. 35 रुपए का आपको ये चिप मिलेगा. ये चिप आपका मेन इंपॉर्टेंट माइक्रो कंट्रोलर बोर्ड का, माइक्रो कंट्रोलर ही यही है. माइक्रो कंट्रोलर 35 रुपीस है और इसका बोर्ड 600 रुपीस को आपको मिल रहा है. ठीक है, सो माई क्वेश्चन इज, इफ आई बाई ओनली दिस आईसी, can I build this board myself and then can I use Arduino IDE and program it is the question. The question is, I will only want to buy this IC, rest everything I want to build myself in my own house or in my own lab. Is it possible to do it? Somebody has built this board for you, can we build your own board for you is the question.
Sir, aisa kar sakte hain kya? Matlab ek board ki jo IC hai usko program kar le फिर उस आईसी को निकाल के ब्रेडबोर्ड पे लगा के वो पिन से कनेक्शंस आउट कर ले।
ठीक है, तो आपको इसका इसका स्पेसिफिकेशन वगैरह आपको कैसे हो सकता, कहां से मिलेगा?
सर वो डेटा शीट में पिन नंबर्स दिए हुए हैं।
पिन नंबर्स तो दिए हुए हैं, लेकिन जस्ट पिन नंबर्स काफी है क्या? फॉर एग्जांपल आई विल गो बैक टू द सेम आर्डिनो बोर्ड दैट वी सॉ। ठीक है, अभी एक पिक्चर है, यहाँ पे चिप है, ये माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एटमेगा का माइक्रो कंट्रोलर चिप है। ठीक है, तो इसके नीचे जीपीआईओ है। ठीक है, यहाँ पे एक 16 मेगाहर्ट्ज का क्लॉक लगा हुआ है।
हाँ सर, ये एक्सटर्नल लगाना पड़ेगा फिर।
हाँ, वो क्लॉक कहाँ से लगाना पड़ेगा, ये सारे डिटेल्स डेटा शीट में है
सर। इसके नेट पे एक सर्किट डायग्राम भी आ रहा है इसका ही,
नेट पे सिर्फ आर्डिनो को आ जाएगा क्योंकि आर्डिनो बहुत इजी है, इसलिए मैं एक दूसरा माइक्रो कंट्रोलर चूज किया है। वो माइक्रो कंट्रोलर का है STM32F042F6। इसके लिए नेट में कुछ नहीं है। See, Arduino, you can get something from internet. But the issue is, if I choose some other microcontroller, how will I do it?
Yes, sir. Sir, doubt to hai, sir.
So, wo bhi main aapko samjha jata hun, so that you will also understand how to do it. So, what is my microcontroller? STM32F06. Kya hai? Mujhe bhool gaya. F042F6, ha? Theek hai. STM32F042. K6 or F6 or what? F6. Okay. Now what I have done is I have downloaded one. Sorry. Madhurima, can I take for 10-15 minutes more? Is it okay? Okay, so this is the STM data sheet. Because I want to do it for STM, because Arduino is very easy, is available in the internet. That's why you can do it. ठीक है, यहाँ पे हम लोग data sheet जाके data sheet is visible, no? You can see the data sheet, right?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Yes, sir.
Now you can go inside. This gives you the architecture. This is a little complicated microcontroller. That's why the architecture is also complicated. So you can go and then you can actually go and read what are the things that you have to do. I'll show you some examples. The pin configuration de diya hai. तो ये एक ये पिन हम लोग यूज करेंगे। सारे डिटेल्स है, वी हैव टू सी व्हाट डिटेल्स यू वांट। फॉर एग्जांपल यू सी नाउ देयर इज एन एमसीयू पिन। सो एमसीयू पिन, हाउ टू कनेक्ट वन लोडिंग कंडीशन, हाउ टू कनेक्ट वन इनपुट वोल्टेज, द सर्किटरी इज गिवन। नाउ आई कम हियर, सो हाउ टू गिव पावर सप्लाई टू दिस माइक्रोकंट्रोलर। From the pin description, you can find out where you have to give VCC, all these things. So if you come here, no, for every, for example, next to GPIO, I have to connect 200 nanofarad capacitor and one 4.7 microfarad capacitor. So now here, in A, for the ADC, you have to connect 10 nanofarad capacitor here and one microfarad capacitor here. So like this, the data sheet will provide you the details. Based on the details, you can build your own board. ठीक है, समझ आया? So data sheet understanding and reading data sheet is a very important task, and if you can build your own board, that is a basic fundamental knowledge that you need for applying for any job in an embedded computer systems. Okay, now I will show you my own. So the same STM controller I have built myself. I will show you how this schematic works. Okay, now this is the same STM32F046. If you see here, I have connected VDD, then I have connected two capacitors, then I have connected two capacitors over here. So these are all, these values of capacitors are all taken from the data sheet. And here there is pin number 2 and 3, PF0, PF1. Next to PF0 and PF1, if you see, I have connected a crystal. the crystal is going to be my 16 megahertz clock. And ultimately, I have also connected to GPIOs and programmer ports. Okay. Ultimately, then I convert this into a PCB board. How will I convert also? I'll show you. One second. I'll show you. Okay. Now, ultimately, this is my PCB. Okay. And I have done this entire thing in a software called KiCad. There are thousands of software. The easiest software I can think of, which gives you student version, is Eagle. And I have used KiCad because I like more of open source. That's why I use KiCad. If you see here at the center, no, we can see the IC pins. And then I have drawn tracks to different pins. So ultimately, I can also see how does it look like in terms of 3D viewer. So ultimately, this is my PCB. This is the PCB which I built myself completely from datasheet value. You can see the IC is here. I have put some capacitors here. Then I have put some voltage regulator here. I have given some general GPIO pins. These pins, I will use it to basically connect. And then you can see the tracks here. And I can also rotate this and see how does it look like. You can see how does it look like. It's a two-layer PCB board. So the backside also have some switch. I have some capacitors at the backside, which you can also use it for communicating. So this board completely has been built by me sitting in my home using a laptop. Okay? Samajh aaya?
Yes, sir.
Kuch questions hai? Okay, I'll show you my own board now. So I have also used one simple Atmega 328P, which is Arduino. So I purchased one. I don't know how many of you guys can see my camera. See, I purchased one Atmega 328P IC. You can see the IC from my camera?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Visible?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
You see, I have my IC and I just simple. I got crystals, I got capacitors, all these values I got it from datasheet. I simply use a breadboard and basically connected using wires. And sir, actually using one USB driver, I can actually program this using my Arduino IDE. And this totally costed me 100 rupees. I've kept one LED also to check whether my program works properly or not.
Yes, it's great, sir.
Okay, can you see it now?
Sir, how to connect this with the computer?
I need one FTD232 converter to convert serial. So if you go to Atmega 328 data sheet, it will tell you how to actually communicate for programming. You can do serial programming, you can do parallel programming. I am using serial programming and then I'll communicate using a FTD232 chip, which will convert my USB program to this program so that I can program it using the serial input output pins available in my this Atmega chip.
Sir, will you please sort it?
You want to see it again?
No, sir, by which we can operate this to computer.
Okay, that chip is not here with me because I did that in my college. So it's in my college lab. It's not here. I don't have it here because I did the programming in my college. I left it there. Because of lockdown, it's there. I'll show you some FTD232 chip. I'll show you some things available in... see, I'm just Googling it. I'll show you the Google link. Okay, you see, there is, I've checked, this is my chip. So there's one small board. I think this is costing you around 200 rupees or something. 220 rupees from Robo.in. You can check on other websites also. So these five pins, I will connect it to the breadboard to connect it to my microcontroller. And this side, I will connect a wire between my laptop or my computer USB. Then I'll program it using my Arduino IDE. Only thing is, your Atmega 328P should be bootloader, has to be loaded. You have to make sure that the bootloader is loaded already. If you can check that, then it is easy. That's it. This then connect with this, and then it will work.
सर इसमें ओरिजिनल और क्लोन का कुछ इशू रहता है क्या
क्या क्या क्या क्या
सर मतलब हार्डवेयर शॉप से खरीदते तो कभी कभी ओरिजिनल नहीं मिलता है तो क्लोन लेना पड़ता है तो सर उस केस
प्रॉब्लम क्या है इफ योर एटमेगा 328 हैज बूट लोडर देन ऑल दीस थिंग्स विल वर्क अदरवाइज इफ यू वांट टू बाय इट फ्रॉम अ प्रॉपर वेंडर यू बाय इट फ्रॉम एलिमेंट 14 और आरएस कंपोनेंट्स
ओके सर सर उस केस में मैंने नेट पर देखा था तो CH40 ड्राइवर्स इंस्टॉल करने का बता रहे थे वो
सॉरी
मतलब सर मेरे लैपटॉप से वो सीरियल कनेक्शन एस्टेब्लिश नहीं हो रहा था तो उस केस में CH40 ड्राइवर्स इंस्टॉल करने का बता रहे थे
दोस थिंग्स एंड ऑल यू हैव टू फिगर इट आउट सो इट इज नॉट सिंपली इन वन गो इट विल वर्क आई हैव आल्सो इंस्टॉल्ड बूट लोडर्स 2-3 टाइम्स इन दिस काइंड ऑफ बोर्ड
Okay, sir.
So, इसलिए मैं बोल रहा हूँ, because doing these things is not going to be easy. It is going to be tough. But if you have interest, if you can do it, then that is something because you are passionate about it, you are interested in this. That's why you are doing it.
Sir, how did you upload programs in this IC?
No, I already had bootloader inside this microcontroller. Okay. Then I went into Arduino IDE. Then I have written some simple Blink program and downloaded this into this. Using a USB chip that I showed.
Sir, how to install bootloader inside this? We install without this RD.
You can Google it and find out. There are ways of doing that. There are YouTube videos which shows how to download bootloader to this.
Which programming language did you use in this?
I use Arduino IDE. No, I use Arduino programming. That is something very similar to C.
Okay.
Okay, so finally, I'll share this list of books. Okay, so if anybody wants to take a note of it, you can take a note of it. I have given my email ID also at the bottom. Okay, my email ID is srivedevan@gmail.com. So if anybody wants to basically pursue, do some projects, or if you're interested in basically learning something. But I will not give you simple projects where I can simply program and do it. I'll ask you to do all these fundamental exercises. So if you are really interested, if you are ready to put your time, then you are interested to contact me.
Sure, sir.
Okay. So any questions, any doubts, if you want to give any feedback, you can also give your feedback to me. And since it is completely online, I would not be able to see whether you guys have got interest or not, whether you guys understood or not. So that is a major problem in these kind of online sessions. But I hope at least you guys understood what I'm trying to communicate. Please let me know if you have any comments or questions. Okay, so you guys are happy with
Sir, PPTs mil sakti hain humko?
Kya PPT hai?
Sir, jo aapne uske bare mein bataya tha na, embedded system ki jo PPTs wagaira thi.
Theek hai, main bhej deta hu. Main inko bhej deta hu, Madhuri ma ko bhej deta hu.
ओके सर थैंक यू
वो तो सिंपल चीज है जो भी बुक्स है जो भी इंटरनेट में है उससे कॉपी करके फिर पीपीटी बनाया एनीवेज आई विल सेंड यू दैट आउट
सर
एनीवे आई थिंक ऑल दीस आर रिकॉर्डेड आई थिंक यू कैन आल्सो गेट दिस रिकॉर्डिंग्स इफ मदिरिमा कैन डू इट
सर
यस
व्हाट आर द बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट टू बिल्ड अ सर्किट और माइक्रोप्रोसेसर व्हिच शुड आई कवर
क्या है अभी अभी हम लोग किया है वो वाला है क्या?
नो सर, मतलब कि जो भी बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट होता है किसी भी सर्किट को बिल्ड करने के लिए, वो क्या क्या मतलब कि हम कवर करना पड़ेगा तो
इजी होगा। बेसिक्स चाहिए, बेसिक्स को नेटवर्क थ्योरी, बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स कैसे डिजाइन करें, कैसे डिजाइन करना है बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। तो फ्लॉयड करके एक बुक है इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स का, FLOYD वो ऑथर है।
ओके सर,
ठीक है, वो बुक बेसिक चीज वो चाहिए। फिर आपको नेटवर्क थ्योरी का फंडामेंटल चाहिए और क्या है डिजिटल फंडामेंटल चाहिए, मे बी बेन जी ट्रीटमेंट्स का डिजिटल बुक है या जो भी डिजिटल बुक आपके पास है वो डिजिटल फंडामेंटल चाहिए बस। फिर ये सारे प्रैक्टिस में आ जाएगा, वो प्रैक्टिस के लिए आप लोग मेहनत करना है। सिर्फ एक छोटा सा प्रोजेक्ट ले लो, सो दिस टेम्परेचर सेंसर आई डिजाइन दिस टेम्परेचर सेंसर दैट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन टुडे जस्ट फॉर माय ओन क्लासरूम फॉर माय क्लास। आई स्टार्टेड बिल्डिंग ऑन टेम्परेचर, आई बिल्ट पुट अ रिक्वायरमेंट, देन आई चेंज द रिक्वायरमेंट, व्हाट इफ माय रिक्वायरमेंट बिकम्स 0.1 डिग्रीज, what if my requirement becomes 0.001 degrees, will I be able to still detect it using this temperature sensor? Abhi yahan pe speed nahi hai, so hum log jo bhi discuss kiya I did not include speed. If I include speed, how fast your temperature sensor can respond and how fast your microcontroller is going to give you an alarm, ye sare cheez andar aa jayega. Fir aapko sare data sheets padhna padega, fir wo design karna padega ek system. ठीक है, यस एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस? ओके, सो देन मोर ऑर लेस विल एंड हियर नाउ। ओके, ओ मधुरम आर यू देयर? आई डोंट नो, आई थिंक शी इज नॉट हियर आई गेस। ओके, anyway, thank you so much for attending and thank you so much this TechWeb team from RGPB for arranging this session also. I hope you guys would have had some useful session in this 3 days. I hope you would have learned something, and if you want to pursue this, please let me know, you can contact me. So yeah, you can leave. Thank you so much. Feedback link I don't have, like it is to be with Madhurima.
Thank you, sir.
Madhurima wants to give the feedback link. I don't have the feedback link with me. I mean, I don't know because I'm also an external member coming in here. So, aap log feedback de sakte hain so that I can also see the feedback. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much. Have a good day. Please use this time to basically learn something, whatever you're interested.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
मैम एनी फीडबैक लिंक?
हेलो अविनाश, नो फीडबैक अवेलेबल?
Hello.
हेलो मैम,
बैक अवेलेबल नहीं है।
इसी तरह तो कल भी हुआ था भाई।
हेलो मैम।
यस
हेलो यस Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I think our session is over now, no? So, look, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Feedback link.
Feedback link certificate we will provide after I think within a 1 week on your WhatsApp group. So, otherwise send on your mail ID. It's not now.
Is there any feedback link, ma'am?
Yeah. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
We will provide you the feedback link.
Yes, Yadav. No feedback link available.
We will not provide you the feedback form link.
Yes, ma'am. 1 week.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. And we will provide you the PPTs also.
Yeah.
Or you WhatsApp it. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Avinash Yadav.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Please end the session.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
Yes.